Julian Traeger from Anglo Pacific is with me in the studio this morning. Julian, nice to see you. Welcome.
Good morning, Andrew.
Of course, the last time we spoke, you hinted right at the end of our conversation a further acquisition might not be too far off. News today of a nickel-cobalt project. Development stage, this one. Tell me a bit more.
Yes, I think at the beginning of the year we announced, given the cash that we are generating, that we're going to start to invest in development projects which have a long time horizon but have the opportunity to generate a huge amount of income for us. And this is the first that we're announcing today. So we're only committing $2 million at this stage. But in a tranched way, we could ultimately invest up to $72 million as the project gets up and running. And we've focused on nickel sulfate in particular. We've always been interested in moving into base metals, and obviously nickel's one of those, but nickel sulfate is of particular interest because it's used for electric vehicle batteries, and that market we think is going to grow a lot.
And in terms of how this fits into your wider strategy, being in Brazil, it's a solid jurisdiction.
Yes, absolutely. We're very comfortable with Brazil. We already have a vanadium royalty in Brazil, and we have also an iron ore royalty there as well. So it is a jurisdiction which fits in with our safe exposure globally.
And in terms of the first tranche, that $2 million, that'll be funded from internal cash, will it?
Yes, we have net cash. We also have very big borrowing lines which are totally unused, so we don't have to go to the market to raise capital for this.
And that's I suppose the incremental structure to this deal, that is de-risking the investment to some respect.
Yes, so the two additional tranches are completely at our option, and so we can decide when we wish to pay that, and they are linked to the way in which the project expands. The first tranche is linked to a small plant getting up and running, and the second tranche is linked to a larger plant getting up and running. So we've tried to de-risk it, but obviously we've also built in to the arrangement much higher returns than we have had on producing royalties, because there is still development risk associated with the project.
And should you go all the way through, you could end up with, what is it, 5.5% of the project?
Yes, which is quite a high percentage for royalties. And if we do invest the full $72 million, then given our current portfolio, this would be our second largest royalty in due course. So I think we are starting to move the portfolio away from bulk materials like coal towards base materials like nickel, and particularly materials which are going to be used in the 21st century to power the economy.
And particularly towards development stage projects as well.
Well, there'll be more development stage projects. Our internal thinking is probably, you know, 70% will continue to be producing in terms of new investments, 30% will be development. So we'll continue to build up a portfolio of development royalties over time, but you know, you shouldn't expect us only to be doing development things.
Very good, Julian. Nice to see you. Thank you.
Good to see you too.